in this video we will review a data sheet of or a data sheets of a devices used in a project. Okay, the devices of the project we have reviewed its shop drawing and the tender design and riser diagram in previous videos. Okay, now we have here the card types. Okay, and this card is an HID card. This card is 125 kilohertz. Okay, it is not a MIFARE card. Okay, and to know the difference between 125 and the MIFARE cards, you should review the video of access control cards. Okay, and this is the features of this card. This card is an RF programmable card. Okay, proximity access card, offers proximity technology and photo identification on a single access control card. Okay, this is a simple card with an ID. okay, when this card enters the electromagnetic field of a card reader, will transmit its ID. okay, and its ID shall be read by the card reader and send its ID to the controller to decide the credential and identify this ID. okay, and it has many features here. okay, supports format up to 85 bit. okay, and over 137 billion codes. okay, but as I told you, you have two types of card, 125 with its advantages and disadvantages, and my fair card with advantages and disadvantages. okay, and you can review these features one by one, but here we are focusing on the sensitive data or the important data. okay, we have here a durability, long life, passive, which means it has no battery. okay, and as we said, it uses a coil to generate an enough current to operate the internal chip. okay, and we have here the dimension, and the dimension is very important if you are intend to use this card as a card for the for a switch, a power saver. okay, for a power saver, and also this is the operating temperature, the weight, the part number, the description, RF programmable, 125 kilohertz. okay, so in this card we can't assign a specific ID with a specific time with a specific credential to a customers. okay, because this card can hold only the ID. here we have a reader. okay, so this is a card reader, and as we can see, it doesn't have a keypad. okay, so this reader is only a card reader, and it has a multicolor LED with a various paper. okay, so LED used usually green LED or green light for acceptable card and red light for refused card. okay, and we are reviewing this kind of readers for two things. okay, to ensure that the reader will read the access cards we are choosing before, and also to identify the mount type of this card. okay, the back box, okay, or the frame in which this reader will be fixed. okay, we have here the model name and the model number and the read range. okay, it has a various range distance for each card type. okay, We have here 5 centimeters for a specific card and 7.6 centimeter for a specific card, okay? And this is depends on this card's coil, okay? If this card is very sensitive, okay, the distance shall be big, and if it doesn't sensitive, it shall be small and should be narrow to the reader, okay? And we have here the mount, okay, color, it has no keypad, dimension is very important, and here we have the power supply and power requirement, power consumption, okay, operating temperature, operating humidity, and transmit frequency. This is the normal cards, okay. And this is the IP protection or ingress protection number, cable distance, okay, we have here cable distance between the reader and the controller, okay, 150 meters for 22 AWG cable. And we have here the termination type. We have here the certifications, warranty, and whatever, okay. And this is the push button used in this project, okay. And this push button can be installed on a normal back box, 7x7. Current rating 4 ampere at 125 volt AC, and 2 ampere at normal voltage, 250 volt AC, okay. This information is very important because if you are importing these devices outside your country, okay, this device, if it is not a DC device, DC current device, you should keep in mind the operation voltage, okay. In my country, we are working with 250 volt AC, but in America, they are using 125 volt AC. And we have here the weight and the dimension, okay. And this is the main features. Okay, push button. This information, it is not for the push button, okay, it's for the server, okay, but we don't have an image here for the server, okay, and we will discuss the server later, okay, but here we are reviewing the other devices, all access control devices except the server, okay. This is the magnetic lock, okay, and this is its type. Operation voltage 12 volt AC or 24 volt DC per magnet. Okay, we have two options here. Okay, and for current, this is the consumption current. Holding force up to 272 kilograms. Okay. And hole effect contact rated 2 amperes at 204. Anti rust surface treatment, okay, blue zinc plating. So this is magnet is on anti rust. And operating voltage, operating humidity, and weight 2.2 kilograms, okay, and this is the dimensions. Okay, and as it says, it's ideal for double swing door. Okay, low current consumption, reliable holding. Advantage of this type of contact. Okay, And we have alternative solution here, okay? And nearly the same descriptions, okay? The same previous description, but here we this is suitable for double swing doors, but in this it is not suitable for this kinds of doors, okay? Built-in magnet contact for door status monitoring. Oh, we have here a door contact, okay, to monitor the status of the door, and this is a built-in inside this magnetic, okay. We have a red green, okay, to indicate the status of lock. We have an anti-tamper, and the tamper it used to give alarm in case someone tried to open this access magnetic, okay. And the resistion magnetic kickoff button, okay. And this is also an alternative solution for the double doors, okay. Double doors access. Ideal for double swing door, okay. And almost the same descriptions or the same specifications, okay. We have also alternative solution here, and this is the internal circuit, okay. We have here a jumper, okay, for the supplied voltage, okay, and power output to be connected here, Hall effect sensor to be connect here, Hall effect sensor output to be connect here. We have two types of relays, normal open and normal close, and power input. So power input enter here. And if we connect this this lock to another device, this shall be the output, and also this is shall be the output sensor, okay. We have a door contact here, mini magnet contact, and it used to monitor the door status, okay. It's a symbol. We have here printer, and this printer is used to print the journaling or the recording or any reports generated by the access control software, okay. We have here what we have here the card printer, okay. It is not just assign ID to the card, but it can also print an image or a specific frame on the card, okay, as requested by the client, okay. Direct to card die sublimation resin thermal transfer, okay. Print capabilities, edge to edge, manual to side to sided printing, and this is the print resolution 300 dot per inch, and the print speed up to 200 card per hour one side or 155 card per hour two sides, okay. This is for color, okay, and for monochrome, which is black and white, 830 card per hour one side, okay, black high quality. And the card, this is the card capacity, physical dimension, weight, connectivity used USB 2 bidirectional, or it can be connected using an Ethernet connection. Warranty, okay, and the full specification. And then we have the used access control server in the system, and we will discuss it in another video. Thank you.